Hey everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem Part 19. And yeah, today we're continuing on from where Lord Mayonnaise died, and that was sad. And darn, the Marquis of Laos knows all, is what he parted ways with us with, parted ways with life with, actually. But anyway, that's beside the point. The point is, despite the pain it brings, something about Ella with this newfound knowledge to his heart, he sets out for Laos once again. Yay! We travel through a Kalin village. Apparently, they decided to rest there for the night. Chapter 13X, The Peddler Merlinus. So, this will be an interesting mission, and will be quite a useful side mission. We'll have to? Why will we have to? Fine. Prepare the camp. Fold out the camp. Inflate the inflate the things you can inflate. I don't see the need. What's this about Lindis? It's a pity that we don't have time to see her, lover boy. We're not. Hector, don't make me angry. You would not like me when I am angry. My hair literally catches on fire. It is striking. What was that? Did you hear something? Perhaps. Oh, it was a scream. I guess we did hear something. A little more than just something. Someone's being attacked. Of course. Oh, hey. Hello. Someone, help.
Yeah, stupid fool. He's kept us running in circles for hours.
My valuable merchant dust. What are you going to do?
Hey, look at this. The old fool's wealthy.
Ho ho ho. I like it, eh? Hey, pudum.
Let go. Let go.
What a racket. Pudon, can we get rid of this simpleton?
I suppose so. There's no reason to let him live.
Am I? Yeah! I don't really know how to do that scream. Then again, I don't really scream like that very often. Release him!
Who?
I told you to let the man go! If you move quickly, we'll let you live.
Ah, a pair of dandies like you. You know what I think? Living off your parents' names, pressing about, I despise you. Come on, don't hold back. We'll kill you all. Ha ha ha.
Hey! You, they call you Joel, am I right? I'm Merlinus, a humble and lowly merchant. I know nothing of combat. Please, you must protect me. Why are you talking to me? I'm the one who's also standing behind everyone. Namely, whoever is in charge. Okay, so yeah, we have another defend mission, but this, or another save person mission, not another save Merlinus mission, just another save someone mission. Merlinus, a traveling merchant, timid and easily frightened, as you can tell. He also speaks very quickly and is always busy. Civilian, an innocent peasant with no combat skills at all. Yeah, not the most useful. But yes, we are going to protect him, because why not? So yeah, that's largely what's going to happen this mission, is we're going to protect him for a couple turns to do stuff. To make sure that we uphold our honor. Right, Elwood? Right?
Right, guys?
Why are the arrows starting down here? Oh, hey, guy. What's up? What's up, guy? So, yeah. You'll have... This will be an interesting area because there will be a lot of enemies that will try to attack this and slowly break it down so that you're going to have to defend there as well. So, look forward to it. Look forward to them assaulting the area, because that sounds fun. I didn't kill that archer. Rats. Actually, I'm just going to do this. This is something you can do. Got to pick Merlinus up with Marcus. Yeah. So now they're going to have to kill Marcus before they can hurt Merlinus. Which is kind of funny. Plus, this allows Rebecca the opportunity now to go kill that archer and get a level up. And Elwood already got a level up too. And she's got lucky sevens, just they're not in a row. How disappointing. Now, let's see. Matthew's very useful in this mission because of the fact that he's a thief, so he can increase your vision, which is pretty nice. Yeah, the small amount of space here is kind of limiting, but oh well. Now, I think I might actually send Marcus up to the north there. Well, to the northeast. And actually go to that village. Yeah. I think that's what we'll do with him. Because I want to see what's in that village. Because I actually don't remember either. This is another nice use of Marcus. Is just to get to these places where it's more dangerous to get to. And you're put at a higher risk when going to. But where the rewards are nice. So we're just going to do this. We're going to trade with Merlinus, send him a sword so he can actually deal with guys that try to block him, and take Merlinus and run off this way like a loon. And oh, Rebecca can't actually finish him off. How interesting. But Hector can, because he's not loon. Yes, I went there and healed him up and almost reaching level 7. That'll be nice once she actually does reach level 7. So we're gonna try. Aw, he missed. Sadness. Loan, stay there for backup if I can rely on you for backup. I think we'll just have Dorcas and Guy defending this lower area and obviously keeping Elwood and everyone else up here. Yay! And drink some coffee. Because it is delicious. Especially coffee with salted caramel syrup. It's delicious. Yep, they're already going for it. But I think once Marcus gets in range, they'll attack Marcus instead. Which is good and convenient. Let's find out if that's true next turn. Oh. Could be an issue. They can almost get up there, but they might go for Marcus. Let's hope they do. Or else we may have already failed in rescuing the village. Which would be sad. Very, very sad. My voice is really deep right now. Sort of. Maybe. Yeah, more magic. How useful. Actually, because it means I can heal for more. Oh yeah, so the mine. Actually, a couple things I forgot to mention earlier that I just remembered from seeing that mine. I don't know why that mine reminded me of them, but that's beside the point. Yeah, first off, units in here, when they die, are dead. For good. You can't do like in Shining Force where you go back to a priest and get them revived. You can't do like in Final Fantasy where you use a life spell or a phoenix down
If they die, they're dead for good. The only exceptions are lords, but if they die, you restart the chapter from the beginning. Yeah, Sir took a hit. That was not cool. We will have to reprimand this nomad. So yes, that is why I restarted the chapter with Matthew dying. I probably won't be doing that from now on, but Matthew, at this point, until after a certain point, is still super, super useful. So, yeah. She can probably take another hit, so I'm gonna heal Hector first, just for some more experience, because that's pretty useful stuff. Kurtu Nomad, you're getting in the way, die! Let's see, what else was it? Oh yes, there is a glitch that you can actually do with a mine. I'm not going to be doing it, partly because I'm too lazy to, because it's... I don't remember how to do it, and I don't really want to bother with looking it up. But, yeah, you can actually use the mine in a glitch where you can actually, basically take control of your enemies. Yeah. It's pretty useful and pretty awesome. It's, what's the word? If I remember correctly, it's kind of complicated to do because you have to have like an enemy step on it, and then you have to turn off your Game Boy Advance, and then turn it back on and resume the chapter right at that exact moment when they stepped on it, and then it'll glitch out where you control them, where you control the entire enemy team for the rest of that turn. So it's a bit complicated, but if you can pull it off, it actually is pretty useful. Especially on missions like the last one, where a guy is really hard to get to, but that makes it much easier because you can put, you can actually make him drop his weapon so he can't attack you and risk killing anyone. You can make all your enemies do that for that matter. And you can move him wherever you want him to be. So wherever would be a good position for him is where you can move him. That's nice. Oh my, those ruffians are attacking you? Our village is in danger too. We talked it over, and here. It's all the money we collected. If you'll chase off the bandits, it's yours. How convenient! 5,000 gold. I will take 2. Or just 1. That's cool too. That's nice, that'll be useful later. Once we need more money. Which we'll definitely be wanting later. And this is the point where Marcus retreats again so he doesn't hog experience. Oswin is amazingly useful for this chapter because you can just completely block off that entire one route without even needing healing or anything, really. It's because he's so tough. It's amazing. Ah, and last turn to save Merlinus. How convenient, we are nearly reaching the conclusion. And you know what? Just out of spite, I'm going to heal Oswin. Actually, no. I don't want to have the risk of 2 nomads being able to attack Sarah and killing her. So Loan, you get healed this time. This time. But not next time. Probably, actually. I don't even know what probably actually there means. Anyway, I think those were the things I wanted to talk about. That's all I remember at this point. Oof, blast, I won't forget this. Blah, blah, blah. Then you're smarter than you look. Get out of here. Alright. I've been saved. We've driven them off. Are you injured? No, not all. As you can see, I'm as fine as can be. As fine as fun can be. As fine as a pea. I'm glad to see that. We'll take a leave then. Let's go, Hector. Wait a moment, please. As a token of my thanks. Do not worry yourself. We did nothing to merit reward. We just saved your life. Don't worry about it. Just worry about it. For a long time.
That's right. You've no need of repeller's junk.
Propeller? Hector!
Oops.
Ahem. I'm Merlinus. Find no other traveling merchant whose goods can compare. Don't let your eyes fool you. I'm quite prosperous.
Huh? You're a merchant? Books and knives and all that, eh? Hector, your manners are terrible. Merlinus, please, pay no mind to what this serf has to say.
No, of course not. I wasn't concerned at,
him. By the way, you do obviously come from highborn houses. Would you grant me the honor of your names?
I am Elwood, son of Marquis of Ferry.
I'm Hector, Marquis Ostia's brother.
Goodness, Ostia, Ferry? The greatest houses in all of Lycia.
Ah, to be saved by noblemen such as yourselves is an honor beyond words.
It's nice to be appreciated for a change. Lately, people just want to seem to want us dead.
Tell me, Merlinus, what are your plans?
Pardon? My plans, Lord? I plan to travel at Lycia selling my merchandise, but it may not be possible in such dangerous times.
If that's the case, why don't you come along with us?
Hector?
Our travels will not be ending anytime soon.
We've gained more people and more items, right? It might be good to have help managing our things.
Oh, now that is a splendid idea.
Managing merchandise is my specialty, after all.
Are you sure?
Quite sure, my lord. To be honest, I've dreamt of working for a noble house. To have my fondest wish granted in such a way, I cannot stem these tears of joy.
Lord Hector, Lord Elwood, take me into your bosoms and keep me safe forever.
Thank you. Well met, Merlinus. We're counting on you. Now, I've got some things I want you to carry.
Yes, of course. Whatever you want, whatever you have, Merlinus will keep.
Cool!
Yeah, that's why you want to do that side quest. Because now...
That coffee is delicious.
Anyway, as I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted by my own self, yes, that is why you want to do that side quest, because you get Merlinus, who is very useful. He can't fight, but he's, he'll carry your stuff, and you can actually, you'll see more with him later, but... He is super useful for item management, and you will want to have him because later on, you can make amazing use of him. So anyway, with that, we come to the end of this episode, and with that, I shall bid you bless.